When we are children, we have very little ability to do for ourselves. We depend on everyone else to keep us protected, nourished, healthy, engaged, and connected, because we're developmentally unable to exercise much influence over life or the world. As we get older, we become more and more a part of a social sphere of influence, and people engaged in various activities to make a world and life that fulfills their needs, intentions, hopes, and dreams. All of the efforts of all of those around us create a pretty profound inheritance of wealth. Not a wealth of money alone, but a foundation of security and an abundance of developments and improvements on life that were achieved by all of civilization that came before us. We assume all of that inherited wealth without any initial contribution to the labor it took to create it. Your iPads, iPhones, cars, clothing, homes, schools, and entertainment are all examples of the culmination of generations of people working together to create a common wealth that was given to you. Now that you're adults, all of those around you that contributed tremendous efforts in this civic project are looking to you to take it up and contribute your share to the effort for the greater good, to give back to the commonwealth that was given so freely to you out of love, respect, and trust. It's time for you to ensure that trust that was placed in you. It's time to get involved.
So what is civic engagement?
Civic engagement to me means that, you know, we are a part of a campus community, so civic engagement means going above and beyond, doing your part, and engaging with your campus community, your college community, and even the community outside of our campus. That can be just getting involved in an organization, doing some community service in our community, things like that.
Civic engagement means getting to know each other, like how always we do. We make sure we have programs to build our community and also our floors, whether it's passive or active.
Civic engagement is where people in the community realize that there's some sort of a community need, and they make an informed decision that they are going to be the difference for that community need.
My grandmother was 20 when women won the right to vote in the United States 100 years ago. She had to wait a year to cast her first ballot because the voting age was 21 back then. She never missed an election and was a delegate in her party's local conventions. She knew the importance of civic engagement. She didn't take voting for granted. She let her voice be heard. You can too. Vote.
My grandfather fought alongside the rest of the greatest generation to oppose fascism and rose to the greatest challenge that the United States of America had ever faced in fighting during World War II. His bravery and the sacrifices that others have made to give us the freedom to vote and the ability to have democratic elections is something that I carry with me every time I go into the voting booth.
If you want to know why you should be civically engaged, particularly during elections, well, it comes down to a couple things. One, the United States is the most powerful and it has the largest economy of any political system in human history. That means you, in your small way, are not just functionally responsible through your vote, through your elected officials, for the policies that affect the 300 odd million Americans, but for the 7 billion human beings on this planet. We are potentially the greatest force to change the world in the history of our species. And that comes with a moral responsibility.
As a political science professor, I often ask my students on the first day of class, so, how does government impact your life?
Government gives me rights. It allows me to speak my mind freely.
Financial aid, for me and my roommates, we get food stamps, so we are able to eat lots of food when we need it.
Nothing.
You go, Ashley.
They try and make sure
that we don't do stuff that's wrong.
Yeah.
They try and keep us, make us everything like school safe and everything.
They make laws to keep people safe.
I think the government, what it's doing right now, is a lot different than what I think it should be. It should be the protectors, the ones who guide us, make sure that everything stays safe and secure. But I don't think it's felt like that for at least the past decade, maybe. Anything you're doing, like Medicaid, you know, housing.
They pass laws and stuff like that that regulates the entire United States. It provides opportunities for people who wouldn't get it otherwise, like public education. I think it helps people in most cases.
Okay.
It's providing resources for people who wouldn't get those resources any other way.
I think it's the force that helps guide us make decisions. I think it's not an overwhelming thing that makes all of our decisions hard and fast, but it's something that helps us, give us the guidelines to make the right decision in life.
The government keeps everything orderly, or at least it's supposed to, and it makes sure that people are fairly rewarded and fairly punished for what they do.
Government is involved in all of our lives from the moment that we wake up until we go to sleep. Now, that doesn't mean that the federal government is in our lives constantly, though you could make that case as well. But we do have different layers of government in our lives, from things as simple as setting the time on our clocks from when we wake up, to the nutritional facts that are in our food when we eat it, to taking transportation, to, you know, seatbelt laws and laws about how fast you can go on the highway. And then once you get to college, if you're a college student, things like access to labs and access to computers and equipment and your tuition and so many things about the financing of the buildings and the water that you use to shower with. Like, everything is affected by government.
The world also affects us. We're enmeshed in systems of trade, in alliances, in balances of power. In these, a shared environment, we share common water and air and a biological world. We share space and a vast array of different things with every other human being on this planet. We are deeply enmeshed with everyone on Earth. And the only way you could have a say in that is meaningful, is to get informed and to choose people who will represent you in Congress, in the White House, and to a lesser degree in the state legislatures, who will represent your interests and your needs and your ethics on the broader global stage.
I've always been an independent voter, and I vote for the person, not for the party. And so with civic engagement, it's, you need to be involved. You need to be actively finding out where the candidates stand. You need to figure out what is important to you.
I don't get involved.
Let me think, hold on.
Maybe.
No, I'm not really a big political person. I mean, I just kind of go with the flow with everything else that's going on with the world.
Well, I have an opinion on almost everything.
COVID and stuff like that.
Global warming, anything like that.
Climate change is probably the biggest issue facing our generation.
Economics a lot. There are stocks. I want to invest.
I know personally I've had to take out a lot of loans for school, and that's going to be rough paying it back.
If there was one thing that I wish that we could do better, it was like our school system.
Yeah.
I'm also really dedicated to school funding, because I plan to be a teacher one day. So when schools are underfunded, I found that really kind of appalling, thinking that that's our baseline for what we have going on in life. And I think that schools should be, and teachers definitely should be, more well paid.
My most important is the civil rights of people.
Black Lives Matter.
Black Lives Matter.
Gender and sexual rights, such as LGBT rights.
Native American rights, definitely.
Social issues, I think there's definitely a lot of turmoil going on socially.
There are some problems in the police department.
Yeah.
How it's easier to become like
it's easier to become something else, and then it doesn't take as long to become a police officer. And I feel like if they are able to have weapons on them and they're able to like determine the rest of somebody's life, then I feel like they should have more regulations and they should have a longer period of time to become a police officer.
Keeping people safe, you know, foreign policy, that those kind of things are top of the list for me.
Living in this area for all my life, pretty much all you hear is drugs and a lot of people's, I guess, warped views of the government.
And the decreasing of the role of religion in public affairs. You know, no more religion in the court, no more religion in politics, because I think that it should not affect politics, if you know what I mean.
That's how you need to figure out how to vote, because that is your voice in the government.
Government also can't handle everything, which is where civic engagement is so important. Civic engagement does mean that people register and they vote, but it's more than that. It also means that people are active on things that government can't quite handle.
We're all members of communities, so we have a shared social responsibility for engaging in community service, including voter participation. We can share the spirit of engagement with our family and our friends, so serving communities together as a social activity is a powerful way to bond and strengthen our community ties as well as our relationships to one another. When we care about a place and the people who live there, it's so much easier to be motivated to take social action. When we feel like we're part of our communities, it's very rewarding to do community service and volunteer and participate in so many other very important forms of civic engagement.
There are needs in all of our communities that people can help with and find ways to better their communities. And it takes all of us to have a really healthy democracy and to make the world a little bit of a better place.
While we'd all prefer to sit back and have others do the work for us or hope for some superhero leader to step in and solve all our problems, that's really not how we got to where we are, and it's not how we'll sustain that great civic wealth into the future. The person you are waiting for to make the world a better place is you. Don't worry, you're not starting from scratch. Think of all that you have. All that was built for you or taught to you by others who built it with and learned it from the buildings and teachings of those who came before them. You've got everything you need. It doesn't require superpowers. You are standing on the shoulders of generations of people serving other people. Now, it's time for you to help others to climb up, to see the world, and to reach for a better tomorrow. Will you lend a hand? Si c'est né, ça te met, tu ne te meurs, tu